We're helping make sure that no orchids go extinct. And we do this using morphological information, what they look like and their DNA. Globally, about 40% of plant species are threatened, and related to this, climate change is recognised as a major driver of biodiversity loss. My name's Heidi Zimmer. I'm a scientist at the Australian National Herbarium in the Centre for Australian National Biodiversity Research. The main concern about climate change for Australian orchids is that we have many narrow range endemics. That's species that occur in really restricted geographic areas, sometimes only over a few kilometres. And so if the conditions change there, it might become unsuitable for the species, and that would be bad news. Many orchids rely on specific pollinators like bees or butterflies and specific mycorrhizal fungi. Those are the little fungi that live in the roots, and the conditions need to be perfectly suitable for them as well. So slight changes in temperature or moisture could have a big impact, as could extreme events like floods, fires and droughts. Okay, the Orchidaceae, the orchid family. What comes to mind for most people when they think about orchids might be those orchids that you can buy in the supermarket, usually in pink or white. Well, they're just one species of orchid. They're probably a Phalaenopsis species. Those species are native to Asia. But orchids are so much more than that. There's about, 28,000 species. They range from things with tiny flowers that are only a couple of millimetres wide up into things which are a couple of tons, like the gramatophyllum, which are found in Papua New Guinea. Or you might have heard about, but not realised it's an orchid, Darwin's orchid. So back in the day, Darwin discovered this orchid that had a 30 centimetre long spur. And he was like, oh, there must have been something to pollinate this, something with a 30 centimetre long tongue. And then 150 years later, we found that moth with that long tongue. It was crazy.
Climate change is an important threat to orchids. To help slow this threat, scientists at the CSIRO's National Research Collections Australia are using taxonomy to ensure these species are well defined so that conservation management actions can be targeted. In a recent review of threats to Australian orchids, Jenna Raith and Catherine Pickering showed that climate change was underrepresented as a threat to Australian orchids. I think this is not because it isn't a threat, it's more because we don't understand the impacts well yet.
The IUCN Red List of Threatened Species is the most comprehensive list of threatened plant and animal species in the world. It contains all the key information. And recently we did a project to see if we could include some more Australian threatened orchids on the red list. We did this by looking at orchids which were endemic to Australia and were listed on the Australian Government Environment Protection and Biodiversity Conservation Act. And we took the information from those assessments and transposed it onto the red list. And that increased the number of Australian orchids on the red list from 28 to 51. This work is really important because it helps with prioritisation and coordination across borders, which helps with resourcing conservation globally. What's our overall aim? It's a list, but not just any list. It's a comprehensive, well-defined, evidence-based list of orchids, of all the orchids in Australia. Once we have that well-defined list, we can work out which species are threatened and which ones we need to conserve. And we'll know we're on the right track when we've got effective on-ground conservation happening for the species in need.